The next kind of strong oracle that I'd like to talk about is what I would call a function inverse pair. We have available to us some sort of function, and also its inverse, and as a pair, and we can use these as a pair to do strong checking of correct behavior of the software under test. And so if we remember a couple of units ago, I gave the example of where you could test an assembler by pairing it with a disassembler, and also an exhaustive enumerator for instruction encodings. And then what we would do is take all valid instruction encodings, disassemble them into assembly language, reassemble the assembly language into machine code, and do a comparison on the output. So that's what I'm talking about when I mention function inverse pairs. If we think about it, we can find these function inverse pairs a lot of places. So another example is encryption and decryption, compression and decompression, saving and loading of files. And this isn't as trivial as it sounds. So I'm not talking about an example where we take some sort of a bitwise representation in memory and dump it literally to disk and then load it again. That's unlikely to go wrong. On the other hand, many times when a program saves its state to disk, this is a pretty non-trivial operation. We might, for example, be replacing machine pointers with some sort of an on-disk representation, and then the load operation is going to contain the inverse, but it's pretty easy to get that wrong. Or maybe, perhaps, we forgot to save part of the program state, and then when we load it, we'll end up in a different state. We'll be able to catch that by treating save and load as a function inverse pair. Transmit and receive across some sort of a loopback interface, that is to say, a network interface that connects a machine to itself, can serve as a useful oracle, because in some cases, they're non-trivial transformations of data representation that happen as part of the transmit and receive operation. And finally, encoding and decoding of, for example, media formats. So this is a final example of a function inverse pair. And I know there must be a bunch of these that I'm missing, but these are sort of the ones that I could think about. But these are the ones I could come up with just sort of sitting down and brainstorming for a couple of minutes. If you have a function inverse pair, use them together and try to see if you arrived at the original data. And of course, this may not always be as easy as it seems. So for example, when we save pointers to disk and we swizzle them into some sort of on-disk representation, when we load them, the pointer values may have changed, but the shape of the data shouldn't. So some sort of abstraction is going to be required to compare the saved and loaded version. Similarly, the encode and decode of media files often involves a lossy encoding step. So if we encode something as a JPEG and decode it, then, of course, the bits that we get back are not going to be the bits we started with. But on the other hand, they shouldn't be too different. If we can somehow quantify how different they are, then we might be able to use even a lossy encode-decode pair as a test oracle for something like a JPEG encoder and decoder.